Your Honor Part 10 Season 1 Episode 10 Editors Rating 3 Stars Your Honor Part 10 Season 1 Episode 10 Editors Rating 3 Stars Photo, Skip Bolen, Showtime There was always going to be a lot, too much, really, to sort out in the Your Honor finale, which not only has to conclude the trial of Carlo Baxter, but mete out justice to Michael and Adam Desiato, and pay off the involvement of Nancy Costello, Lee Delamere, Charlie, and Kofi's little brother Eugene, who is the only surviving member of his family. And it was hard to guess what shape justice would take, what narrative punishment would be appropriate for the Desiatos, who have many more deaths on their consciences than just Rocco Baxter and who could not be expected to get off scot-free. It's our demand as viewers that screenwriters be the administers of cosmic justice, which generally produces a tidiness that real life almost never mimics. And in writer Peter Moffat's defense, there's probably no ending that could balance the equation here. Kofi's murder and the subsequent death of his mother and three of his siblings cannot be answered by any machinations of the plot, save maybe for the deaths of both Desiatos, three-fourths of the Baxters, and Big and Little Mo. And perhaps a maiming of Charlie. Or an end to his political ambitions. But Moffat essentially chooses the Godfather Part III ending, with the son catching an accidental bullet and the father cradling him in his arms, having paid the steepest price for his sins. It's not a one-to-one comparison, Adam is guilty, after all, and Mary Corleone is an innocent, but the parallels are unmistakable. But before casting judgment on the ending, let's issue some verdicts on other parts of this rocky finale. One benefit of Moffat pulling the strings as relentlessly as he does is that many of the major characters have to confront the same, what would you do, question that led to this cascading tragedy. Nancy and Lee, especially, have to at least puzzle over it a little before they can righteously grill Michael for his lies. Nancy discovers that the Desiatos' clever alibi, a veteran watching the cemetery gate near Robin Desiato's grave, remembers exactly when they visited, since it was the same day his unit was massacred in Vietnam. Lee also discovers that the blue station wagon was stolen the day after Rocco's death and is mostly able to piece together the rest from there. The strongest scene by far in the finale has Lee coaxing the truth out of Michael in chambers and hearing a full-throated defense of his behavior. Justice and principle do not take precedence over the life of your child, he tells her. And if the truth were to come out to the Baxters, Jimmy Baxter would kill Kofi. Would the death of another 17-year-old make everything better? Michael is asking Lee, at a minimum, to allow him to take the fall for his son, but she isn't having it.